In this video, I will show you how to count times in a specific range in Excel like this. So let's get started. Here in this Excel sheet, I have some cells containing time values in this column. Now I want to count the cells containing time in a specific range. For example, the count of cells between times 8:30 and 9:30 a.m. will be 3, while the count of the cells between times 9 and 10 a.m. will be 2. To count the cells between two times or a time range, we can use the COUNTIFS function. The COUNTIFS function returns the count of the cells in a range that meets one or more criteria. We can provide more than one pair of range and criteria arguments to this function. To count the cells containing time in a specific range, I am going to count all the cells that is greater than or equal to the first time and less than or equal to the second time of the range. For example, to count the cells between 8:30 and 9:30 a.m., I am going to count the cells greater than or equal to 8:30 a.m. and less than or equal to 9:30 a.m. Let's start the formula by typing an equal sign in the target cell. Now type COUNTIFS followed by an opening bracket. Select all the cells containing time as the first argument followed by a comma. Since we want to count all the cells greater than or equal to the first time, type greater than or equal to sign followed by the time 8:30 in the double quotes. Type a comma and reselect the cells containing time as the third argument. The second condition will be less than or equal to the second time in the range, so type a less than or equal to sign followed by 9:30 in the double quotes. Type the closing bracket and hit the enter key to complete the formula. As you can see, we now have the count of times in a specific range. Instead of hard coding the time values directly into the formula, we can also use the cell references containing the start time and end time. Let's modify the formula to do that. I will use the ampersand character to join the greater than or equal to sign with the cell reference like this. I will make the same changes to the second condition as well. As you can see, we got the same results after using the cell references instead of the hard-coded time values. Using the cell references instead of the hard-coded values is the correct way to create this formula because it is dynamic. That means when we change the start or end time, we do not need to update the formula. Since the cell values are referenced instead of hard-coded, the count of the cells will be updated automatically. Watch these videos to learn more Excel tips, tricks, and how-to tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.